Welcome to No Tech with E2 today. Today, let's take a moment and talk about power banks. You hear a lot about people saying we're going to buy a power bank to boost our phone. Whenever we travel or we go anywhere, we're going to use the power bank to charge our phones. And you now go to a taxi rank or any dodgy place, you say you want to buy a power bank. They sell you a power bank and you find that it's not what you needed because it can't even fill your phone with battery. So what I'm going to be advising you, when you buy a power bank, you need to know how many milliamp hours are you buying. Most of the cell phones that we use today, they use 2,500 milliamp hours. If a charging brick or a power bank doesn't have 2,500 milliamp hours, it's not a good enough power bank. It may cost R100, it's fine, but then it won't give you what you need. So you need to know how many milliamp hours your phone takes, and you need to go and buy those milliamp hours. I use an iPhone 5C. It takes about 2,500 milliamp hours. I have a power bank that is 4,000 milliamp hours. So I know for sure that if it's full, if my power bank is full, it can charge my phone at least 1.5 times. It can charge my phone full, and it can charge my phone halfway for the second time. So I know if I have to travel for a day or two, I don't need power, I can recharge on my way. So guys, you need to know how many milliamp hours are in your battery, are in your smartphone. So milliamp hours, don't forget, milliamp hours, M-A-H, milliamp hours. Sharp, sharp. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I appreciate it.